Hi, my name is Mike Treen. I'm the National Director of Unite Union in New Zealand, and we represent workers in the fast food industries and cinemas, call centres, some of the most marginalised and exploited workers in the country, and we've successfully fought these companies to get collective employment agreements. I've also been involved in the global peace and justice movement in New Zealand for many years. In fact, some of my first actions as a teenager was to join the protests against the coup in Chile back in 1973, and I've been involved in some Latin American solidarity work since that time with the progressive governments that have been formed and have been under attack in Latin America. I am particularly disturbed about what has become very clear is the assassination of the young Mapuche leader in Chile, Camilo, who was, the video footage is showing, was clearly executed, not just killed as an accident in some police action. He was driving a tractor, he was no danger to a risk to anybody, and he was assassinated by the paramilitary forces which are occupying Mapuche lands and trying to drive them off their lands and allow their lands to be exploited. This goes back many decades in Chile, including the periods where those lands were being cleared and offered up to New Zealand companies like Carter Holt Harvey and Fletcher Challenge, big forestry companies, to go in and exploit that land and be complicit in the dispossession of the Mapuche people. So we want to express our complete solidarity with their struggle and demand that justice be served, that people who have killed Camilo be arrested, prosecuted, and jailed as they should be. As the only way that real peace can be achieved is to cease treating the Mapuche lands as a militarized zone and to withdraw those paramilitary forces that have been trained in Colombia and the United States, to withdraw those paramilitary police forces. That this requires a solution, a civil solution, not a military solution. Justice can't come through the militarization and the demonization of the Mapuche people as some sort of terrorist conspiracy when the terrorism is being inflicted on them by the regime. I would also like to express my solidarity with the workers in Chile who have emerged from dark days of dictatorship and are trying to re-establish their rights. They had their rights ripped up by the dictatorship and the imposition of the neoliberal regime. We had many similar things that didn't require a dictatorship to impose that on us in New Zealand. We did that in a sense. We had that done to us, but we had a similar sort of social and political policies imposed on us that resulted in deunionization, weakening of the labor movement, huge increase in inequality, massive wealth transfers, and a destruction of workers' rights more generally. We have seen that occurred. It did occur in Chile, and it's great to see the workers of Chile starting to regain their strength and power as they should. And they need to do if they're going to tackle the tremendous inequality that exists in your society as it exists in our society. Working people need to have that power. And I'd like to, in this particular moment, to express solidarity with the longshore, the warehouse, the workers in the ports of Chile who are taking action to get to achieve their right to a decent collective employment agreement. And restore some of the rights that have been stripped off them in the past. Kia kaha, be strong.